In today's world, views on gender norms vary widely. In the most recent World Values Survey, people were asked, should men have more rights to jobs than women if jobs are scarce? 81% of Jordanians agreed, in sharp contrast to Mexico, where 17% agreed. What has shaped these norms? One theory is that beliefs from the pre-industrial period persist to this day. Pre-industrial societies practiced two different forms of agriculture, plough cultivation and shifting cultivation. Plough agriculture requires upper body strength to control the animal or use the plough itself. Hence, men have an advantage over women. In contrast, shifting cultivation uses tools such as the hoe, which require less strength. Men have no such advantage in shifting cultivation. Since soil preparation makes up one-third of the time spent on agricultural tasks, societies that use the plow had male-dominated workforces relative to societies that didn't, and developed beliefs about the role of women that still persist to this day. In 2013, three economists tested this theory. They found that societies that used the plough had less historical female participation in agriculture and more generally, the workforce. Gender roles today are correlated with both historical female participation in agriculture and historical use of the plough. And by gender roles today, I'm referring to female labor force participation, female participation in politics, and female firm ownership. The authors carefully check for confounds, in particular, whether societies with less gender equality were more likely to adopt the plow in the first place. They controlled for as many factors as they could, especially potential correlates of gender beliefs and plow adoption. Non-agricultural activity, agriculture intensity, land inheritance rules, residence rules, religion, historical migration, communism, oil resources, and warfare. None of these explain the observed relationship between plow adoption and current gender roles. Also, the researchers showed that it is land suitability that determined whether the plow was adopted. As the ease of growing crops that benefit from the plow increases, the likelihood of plow adoption increases. However, the ease of growing similar crops that do not benefit from the plow does not affect the likelihood of plow adoption. Land suitability also predicts gender norms today. Finally, the researchers studied individual-level survey data, including the adult children of US and European immigrants, when comparing individuals within the same country and even state. Those with a heritage of traditional plow use have less equal beliefs about gender roles today. Females were also less likely to be in the workforce. So whenever you speak to someone about any political hot potato issue, be aware that their beliefs may have been shaped by forces that are centuries old.